Very good morning to all the students of class plus 1B as well as class plus 1A. So it's a combined class today and we are going to start new chapter. Both the classes, they have not done this, so it will be easier for you to understand, right? The landscape of the soul, it's on page number 34. Do you have the book, beta? How will you manage then? Try to note down the points, right? So this chapter, I would be sharing the screen with you later, but let me make you understand the concept related to this chapter. The landscape of the soul. So when we hear the word landscape, what comes to your mind, all of you sitting here also? Have you, every person, I guess, has drawn the landscape. You remember that basic painting when mountains are there and a garden area and the river is flowing out of that, trees are there, fine. So this is the basic, in layman's language, you can say, we know, okay, this is the landscape. And then we used to draw a circle and sun and birds. This is the complete view of landscape according to a layman's language, fine. Now, what do you mean by the landscape of the soul? This chapter, the artistic people would be definitely able to relate with it and others also. In this chapter, you will be reading about various art forms, paintings. And especially they have, you know, the very first point is the main theme of the chapter, the first point, as well as it is the main idea, fine. That what we are going to read, you can say the topic sentence of this chapter. This is the contrast of two forms of art, Chinese art, European art. So by reading the first point only, kindly note down all these points, okay? So after reading this, it is quite clear to you. So we are going to read about Chinese art and we are going to read about European art and contrast. What do you mean by contrast? Contrast means difference. If I say comparison, comparison means similarities, fine. If I say contrast, it means differences. So in this chapter, we'll read about different forms of art. Actually, the word landscape, it comes from Chinese people only. And this landscape form of painting was emerged from China only, fine. They started it. But the big difference is that, this is the second point. The second main sentence, European art, which we people follow, fine, that modern art, that is realistic and easily perceivable. Clear? And when we just look at a piece of painting, we are able to understand it, fine. This is very realistic, based on real facts. And the painter just wants to borrow your eyes and make you understand whatever is depicted on the painting. If it's a picture of an animal, you will see an animal. If it's a picture of landscape, you will understand, okay, this is a landscape. That's it. And mainly, I'm just saying. But when it comes to Chinese form of art, these people, when they just draw the landscape, when they paint the landscapes and all, they don't want to borrow your eyes. What they want is, they want to actually go deep into your thinking. They want to steal your thinking only. How? And they want you to understand what they want you to make understand. Trying to get my idea. Clear, Jacqueline? It is not clear to you. Let me introduce you again. So Chinese art says, I will tell you where to look at in the painting. They will give you directions, fine. This is my painting. Here you are seeing this, the meaning of this, 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 fine, in that way. So they will make you understand the complete meaning. That is the Chinese art form. But when we come to European art, that is very realistic. You look at it and you are whatever you want to perceive, that is your choice. Clear? So Emperor Zhuangzong, he commissioned a painter, Wu Dozi, in this. What happens? Firstly, they have told about basic art forms, Chinese and European, and then they will be moving to anecdotes. Now, what do you mean by anecdotes? Anecdotes are short stories. Fine. मैं आपको कहती हूँ कि मैं आपको anecdotes सुनाती हूँ. In that way, it means in Hindi you can say किस्सा सुनाना किसी को कोई. It can be realistic anecdote, असली का, और it can be imaginary anecdote also, unrealistic one. Fine. जो Chinese art है, that is associated with various anecdotes. Which are not true, imaginary, which are not realistic. Fine. So in this chapter, there are multiple anecdotes, various anecdotes. First, we will be reading about the cave story. They are not realistic, but they are imaginary stories. Second, we have related with the Eye of Dragon. Thirdly, we have one blacksmith story and all. So various short stories we are going to read in the landscape of the soul. And after knowing the stories, what we will do? We will make a conclusion. And the conclusion is that difference of Chinese and European art. So through stories, writer has depicted beautifully. Introduction is clear to you all. The children sitting at home, is it clear? Send me thumbs up, beta, so that I can move further. Okay. If any doubt will be there, you can write in the chat box or raise hand, fine? So everybody has noted down these points? All of you? So we'll be continuing the chapter now. Let me share the screen for you all. See, the students, those who are joining now, they won't be able to understand what's going on even. Yuvraj of plus one A is coming now. Yes, beta. Now you can see Natalie Trobroy is the writer of this chapter, Landscape of the Soul. Many new terminology you are going to learn, and about China, a Chinese art form also you will learn. So there are some expressions, beta. You can note down the meanings of these expressions on your book itself. First is anecdote. Anecdote means short tale, T-A-L-E. So write down immediately. Anecdote means short tale. It can be realistic or unrealistic both. Asli bhi ho sakti hai or imaginary bhi. Then we have delicate realism. Delicate realism means it seems to be real. Seems to be real. Means European art form is based on this concept of realism. Then we have figurative painting. Underline this word. Figurative painting means strong projection of real world. Strong projection of real world. Then we have Hellenistic likeness. Now, see, illusion word you might have heard that they are creating illusion. So Hellenistic likeness means pictorial method to cheat your eyes. Pictorial method, P-I-C-T-O-R-I-A-L. Pictorial method to deceive your eyes. Fine? Aankhon ka dhokha create karna. By with the help of pictures only. Fine. This is called illusionistic likeness. Pictorial method to deceive your eyes. And last one is conceptual space. Conceptual space. Space here means various dimensions. Fine. Various dimensions. So conceptual space here means painters will make you understand their painting from various from all the aspects, whatever is possible. Clear? So, vivid dimensions based on concepts. Okay? So, this is the meaning of all the terminology, so that I will not stop anywhere to tell you the meaning. Now you know the meaning and will be able to understand at least two pages today. Let me start this chapter.
A wonderful old tale is told about the painter Wu Daozi, who lived in the 8th century. His last painting was a landscape commissioned by Tang Emperor Xuanzong to decorate a palace wall. So what they're saying, that there is one wonderful old tale. Tale means story. And this story is about Wu Daozi. Underline, this is the first name. And this story belonged to 8th century. And his last painting, which he created or painted, was a landscape. And why he made that last painting, you must know. Wu Daozi is the name of a Chinese painter. He made a last painting of a landscape, fine. And that was ordered by one emperor, Xuanzong. Clear? That emperor asked Wu Daozi that you will be making a landscape so that I can mount it on my palace wall. Clear? The basis clear, beta? Without book, it's very difficult to understand. So the master had hidden his work behind a screen, so only the emperor would see it. So after creating that landscape, what happened after creating that landscape? That master means the master of painting, Wu Daozi. What he did? He just hid that painting behind a screen. And he did not want to show that painting to any other person. And just he wanted to show it to the emperor Xuanzong only. For a long while, the emperor admired the wonderful scene. So when the emperor saw that, he kept on admiring the beautiful scene over there. What he saw, underline, that emperor, he discovered forests in the landscape, high mountains, waterfalls, clouds floating in an immense sky, men on hilly paths, birds in flight. I already told you what is a landscape called, fine? So whatever is there in the landscape, everything was present. And Emperor Xuanzong, he kept on praising the painting made by Wu Daozi, fine? So when he was appreciating, as I already told you, the Chinese form of art does not borrow your eyes. They want you to look at their own point of view. That what I thought, you should also think in that way. So Wu Daozi, he said to his emperor, "Look, sire." Sire means sir in that way. Said the painter, "In this cave at the foot of the mountain dwells a spirit." He says, "See, look at this foothills of the mountain. I want to show you something." The painter clapped his hands and the entrance to the cave opened. So when painter asked him, emperor clapped his hand and cave's door opened. Fine. So this is beta unrealistic tale. Got it? This is not reality. This is an anecdote which is unrealistic. Fine. Associated with Chinese painting. So when he clapped his hand, the entrance of the cave opened and inside was splendid. Splendid here means impressive, beautiful, marvelous. Splendid means beautiful, marvelous, impressive. The inside of that cave was very splendid, beyond anything words can convey. Itna sundar that even one cannot describe in words. Please let me show your majesty the way. Means, let me show you, sir. I will be showing you the way to my painting now. And before the astonished emperor could move or utter a word, the painting had vanished from the wall. Not a trace of Wu Daozi's brush was left, and the artist was never seen again in this world. That painter asked the emperor Xuanzong that, sir, I will be showing you the way into this. The moment he entered, or emperor even could not see, utter a word, or could not even move, though he was not able to perceive, the painting was vanished. Brush was nowhere to be seen. Even the painter got vanished. Fine. So this is the first tale associated with Chinese form of art that is known as cave story. I have written these names myself so that you can remember ki which was the first story. So our first story is cave story, gufa wali story. Fine, so that you can remember it. Clear to all of you? Any doubt, children sitting at home, beta? So that I can continue, send me thumbs up. Fine. So no doubts are there. The cave story is clear to all of you. Now I'll continue to another story. Okay. Why I'm not interacting much today? Because chapters are lengthy, syllabus काफी बड़ा है अभी आपका. Fine. So we'll be reading from here. Such stories played an important part in China's classical education. Point to be noted. These anecdotes, these stories, they are very, you know, prominent. Where they are prominent? In China's classical education. So they teach their children these imaginary stories. The books of Confucius and Zhuangzi, underline these two names. They are great philosophers. Confucius and Zhuangzi, they are Chinese philosophers, thinkers. Fine. So the books of Confucius and Zhuangzi are full of such classical tales. They help the master to guide his disciple in the right direction. Beyond the anecdote, they are deeply revealing of the spirit in which art was considered. So why these stories were formed? Actually, these stories were specifically formed to make one person understand the kind of art. Right? Art ko samjhane ke liye stories banayi gayi. So that is the Chinese form of art. Clear? Many tales are associated with this kind of art. Clear? So anecdote, you already know, short tales. We are on page number 35 now. Contrast this story or another famous one about a painter who would not draw the eye of a dragon. But a second story starts now. First is cave story. Now the dragon story. What happens in the dragon story? Another famous one about a painter who would not draw the eye of a dragon. He had painted for fear it would fly out of the painting with an old story from my native Flanders that I find most representative of Western painting. So as opposite to this story, the cave story, there was one more story related to one painter who drew something and painted a dragon, but he did not paint one eye of the dragon. Why he missed the painting of one eye of the dragon? He believed that if I will be it is just a fake belief. It is a belief, fine? Self-belief of that painter that if I would draw both the eyes, the dragon will fly out of the painting. So I'll make him blind from the one eye. Okay, he will remain blind in one eye and then this painting is fine. He will not fly. So that is just a belief, fine? Flanders, beta, what is Flanders? Flanders is the name of a province. You can search about it. Clear? And it is representative of Western painting, this dragon painting. Then next one is in 15th century Antwerp. You remember the first story, cave story, was situated in 8th century. Now we are coming to 15th century. Antwerp. Underline the word Antwerp. It is a city in Belgium. Antwerp is the name of one of the cities of Belgium. So now we are going to read the blacksmith story. Who can tell me what do you mean by blacksmith? Let me interact a bit. Anyone knows who is a blacksmith? Blacksmith kaun hota hai? Anyone knows? Yes, no idea. rather than speaking wrong, say that I don't know. So what? Acceptance of anything is. Anybody knows? Children sitting at home, beta. Who's a blacksmith? Yes, Jatin of plus one A. You can speak, beta.
A blacksmith is a person who creates tools from iron, steel, from wood.
Okay, very good. You can mute yourself. So he's saying that the person who creates tools with iron and all. So basically, a person who repairs iron work, iron related things. Fine. Suppose a factory is there where iron ores are built up, or iron, other any object is built up of iron. So you might have seen blacksmith wearing very, you know, they have to work in furnace also. They have to use hammer also to change the shape of the iron. It is very difficult. So they melt the iron sometime. They just put hammer on it to give it another shape. So it is very difficult and tedious task. And it is not considered respectable job. Fine. Every job is respectable. But some people, because this blacksmith, this story is related to a boy who loves a girl. Fine. He wants to marry to a girl. And she is the daughter of a very famous painter. And that painter paints beautiful paintings, very realistic paintings, the modern art. And fine, after reading about the Chinese stories, I'm coming to the modern art now. Fine, European paintings. So that man, makes beautiful realistic paintings, and blacksmith wanted to marry the daughter of that painter. Now the painter says, I will not let this boy marry my girl, because he is a blacksmith and he work with irons and all. And this is not a respectable job for my daughter. Fine. So this happens. And the boy thought, I will not let this man demean me. I can also paint. So what he is going to do? He just enters the place where his father has drawn something. And he will be making a fly. Fine. Fly. Pata hai na, makhi hoti hai jo. So he draws a fly on the painting, and it seems to be a realistic fly. His father enters and he sees that on my painting, the fly is sitting. He tries to kill that fly. Means you can very well imagine the beauty created by that boy was so realistic, the modern art. Clear that even the good painter, a master painter, could not realize whether it was a real fly or a fake fly. Fine. So he was impressed with the skill of the boy. Then he allowed that blacksmith. Then finally he got married to the girl. Fine. So understood. Very interesting story. And you might have seen these days 3D arts. You might have seen painters are, you know, going to another level. We see a picture and it seems to be realistic only. European arts, you might have seen on social media. Fine. These days, many videos are being viral. Okay, this child paints, this lady paints, this man paints. And by seeing this, it's quite realistic that we cannot, you know, realize that whether it is real one or the fake one. Okay. So let's continue with the third story, the blacksmith story. So in the 15th century Antwerp, in 15th century Antwerp, a master blacksmith called Quentin Metsys, this is the name of that boy, fine? So in 15th century Antwerp, means in that one of the cities of a master blacksmith called Quentin Metsys fell in love with a painter's daughter. So that blacksmith, named Quentin Metsys, he started liking a girl who happened to be the daughter of a painter. The father would not accept a son-in-law in such a profession. So Quentin sneaking into some place without the permission. He sneaked into the painter's studio and he painted a fly on his latest panel with such delicate realism. Now you know, meaning is written. Is it clear? Which seems to be real. That the master tried to swat it away. Swat means to hit. You know, he thought this is the real fly. Yes, Veta, are you able to hear my voice? There was some connection problem. Fine, so I could not see you all, but now it's again connected. Okay, let's continue. Quinton was immediately admitted as an apprentice into his studio. So apprentice is workman, fine. So he gave job to that boy that, okay, you can paint realistic paintings. So he make him an apprentice into his studio. He married his beloved and went on to become one of the most famous painters of his age, just like the father of that girl. So these two stories illustrate what each form of art is trying to achieve: a perfect illusionistic likeness. Fine. So illusionistic likeness here means pictorial method to deceive eyes. Clear? So this is in Europe, the essence of inner life and spirit in Asia. Now let me give the conclusion to the main theme. In the first story, a cave story, that was basically depicting the Chinese form of art, fine, where the painter Wu Dozi was trying to borrow the thoughts of the emperor Zhuangzong, fine. In the second example of blacksmith story, that boy, he made realistic painting. He did not ask anyone to believe what he made. He made it and it was realistic enough, and his father and her father believed that it is a real fly. So through the stories, these basic two stories, the contrast of Chinese art and European art is depicted. Is it clear to you all? Any doubt? Yes, Vita, children sitting at home, is it clear what is Chinese art trying to say and what is European art depicting to you? Okay, very beautifully the writer has depicted it. So let's continue. Now there will be Vita, now difficult terminology related to China we will be learning. They, you know, believe in many different concepts, philosophical concepts that we will be reading further. In the Chinese story, they have given the conclusion that, let's read that. So this is the conclusion. This paragraph, okay. In the Chinese story, the emperor commissions a painting and appreciates its outer appearance, but the artist reveals to him the true meaning of his work. He needed the help of the artist to understand. The emperor may rule over the territory he has conquered, but only the artist knows the way within. Let me show the way. The Dao, a word that means both the path or the method, and the mysterious works of the universe. The painting is gone, but the artist has reached his goal beyond any material appearance. So they are saying in the first story, the artist, after depicting his true art, got disappeared. Fine. So that was the first way. And you can see one word is written here, that is DAO. There is one word, Daoism. I'll be making you understand what it is. Otherwise, you won't be able to. Daoism. What is Daoism? Chinese people, they believe in this philosophical idea. Clear? That, what is that idea? That they believe that whatsoever, all things whichever exist in this world, they are inseparable and they are contradictory. This takes time to make you understand. Bell has gone, beta.
So I have to stop here. We will continue the next period only. Okay. Have a nice day to all of you.